I wonder how many people value social media marketing. Take what content they consume on social algorithms, for example. What content stars do they pay attention to? Block out? What's the message? Why was it sent? How do you want me to respond? Is it relevant to my needs and interests? Today I've got 7 points for any aspiring business individual or pro on how to be a great social media marketer. Number 1, understand what social media is. If I was to ask you what social media is without labeling the key terms Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat and YouTube, do you think you can give me a detailed definition? Very few people can, so I'll jump straight to it. Social media is the digital communication of connecting and sharing content and ideas that interact and engage with virtual users and communities across online networks. I repeat that. Social media is digital communication for connecting and sharing content and ideas that interact and engage with virtual users across online networks. Without that definition in mind, how do you expect to be a great social media marketer? As you've got to see it as, social media is not a super magical tool for mass broadcasting, but rather, it's a long-term investment for you understanding its virtual nature and who you mutually connect with. For example, if you're into art and architecture, you may like any museum's Facebook fan page. If you're into entrepreneurship and business, you may follow entrepreneur.com on Twitter. And if you're a lady and you're into fashion and lingerie, you may follow Victoria's Secret on Instagram. Don't ask me how I know that. It's all about managing to connect your offline preferences, your likes, your interests, what makes you you from your persona, and enjoying that offline. That's how you make the best of social media. Number 2, know your online audience. Without clear insights of your target audience online, it's not possible for you to successfully market your products or service. Let's take the audiences on both Facebook and LinkedIn, for example. Who are we going to find on Facebook? Everyone across the globe. Well, almost everyone. People from the younger generation to the older generation. Not so much the children and young teens of today, as they're more accustomed to their Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, and YouTube life. Whereas, who we like to find on LinkedIn? Business professionals. People that are CEOs, directors, managers, recruiters. This is the online scope, the online plethora, for them to fuse their professionalism with their career-orientated goals. Let's break it down into businesses, for example. Let's say you're marketing a ladies' clothing line specialized in dresses. You'll be approaching them emotionally on a B2C scale via platforms such as Facebook and Instagram. Now, generally on Facebook, you want to be here building up an audience of dress-loving fans that appreciate your content and you can establish one-to-one relationships with from a social perspective. Whereas when it comes to Instagram, you want to be hiring attractive models that mark out your dresses, your clothing items, from a visual experiential perspective via snazzy pictures and good-looking videos. If you were to say maxi dresses now, ladies like to wear maxi dresses during the summer because they want to look hot, they want to look sexy, they want to stand out from the crowd in any social event. At the end of the day, ladies wear maxi dresses that complement their skin colour, is of a great design, comfy material, possibly even branded, as one of their ultimate aims is so that they can look alarming, figure 8, curves and shape. But if we're marketing IT equipment to corporates and creators, we're going to be approaching them rationally from a B2B scale via platforms such as Google Plus and LinkedIn. Now, these individuals will be asking questions such as, is this computer reliable? Does it support my day-to-day activities? Is what I'm paying for it going to bring me back a return on investment? These are the questions they're going to ask. Know your online audience and their behavioral traits, and you'll know exactly how to market to them, even on social media. Number 3, choose your platforms wisely. Not every social channel is for every business, as you won't find a self-employed driving instructor trying to teach their students a life skill on how to drive, yet they're trying to market up their business on Snapchat, Instagram, as it's not professional, and most importantly, it's not safe. In case a student is trying to turn around a corner, but they forgot to feedback the wheel in time, what happens if they turn around a corner, miss it? That's not going to be a professional look on the driving instructor's credibility, as no one will trust them, they'll lose business. This relates back kind of to my last point on knowing your online audience. Let's look at the four generations and identify what platforms they're likely to be on. Baby boomers, aged 52 to 70, what platforms are they on? Facebook, LinkedIn, and possibly Twitter to push it. What are they into? Cars, luxurious holidays, life insurance, and possibly even houses, you could say. Generation X, early 30s to early 50s, what are they on? Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Google+, and maybe Instagram, depending on their lifestyle or their occupation. Because you could find a 40-year-old woman that owns a bakery business and she wants to mark out her cakes, her pastries, and her bread with, you could say, attractive looking pictures and, say, nice video clips. Generation Y, otherwise known as the millennials, aged 18 to 29. What platforms are they on? Facebook, Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, YouTube, FaceTime, Periscope. Did I miss any out? I don't think. And last but not least, Generation Z, young children to mid-teens. What are they on? Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, YouTube. Anything visual, fast-paced, with little or no text whatsoever. All social marketers must see themselves as the final consumer and ask themselves this question: what brand do I not mind seeing their post on X, Y, and Z platform? Once you know that, you'll know exactly what platform to choose for your marketing. Number four, develop a content strategy. Do you think it's easy to go away and post on social media every single day, having a solid idea of what you're going to talk about and what you're going to post? It definitely isn't. That's where your creativity kicks in for content strategy. But what is one, you may ask? A content strategy is a structured weekly or monthly array of topics and ideas applicable for your social media marketing. I'll repeat that. A content strategy is a structured weekly or monthly array of topics and ideas applicable for your social media marketing. In other words, what type of posts do you look to focus on that engage your online audience with? As it's not about promotion and selling, as this turns off your online audience. Rather, add value to their lives, add value to their social experiences through empowering video clips, you could say even inspirational, motivational quotes, tips on your products and services, before you start putting your offerings left, right, center to them. One must always emphasize with their fans, as always, you gotta think of it this way though. Oh, be a solution to their online needs, their online wants, their online problems, as everyone goes online 24/7, 365, seeking for solutions in life. Make sure that your social profile is their solution. Once you do that, you've got yourself a banging content strategy. Number five, interactive visuals. What's a social post like to you about visual evidence? I'll let you think about that for a second. Definitely think of it this way. Social posts without visual evidence stand less chance to engage, it's not going to interact with people, probably won't captivate, and then people end up scrolling past you in the newsfeed. We all know the saying that a picture's worth a thousand words, yet you've got to know how to take the importance of that when it comes to your social media marketing. Always make it a habit to include relevant, engaging imagery, GIFs, video clips, and even links that make people stop and think, because visuals evoke emotion, hence why the saying goes, a visual worth a thousand words. A thousand words of not just thinking of reading the text, but you're also thinking of more words in your head, thinking of more memories, thinking of more concepts. Visuals actually allow to enhance, accentuate social posts. Make it a habit to include that in your commercial messages. Number six, social monitoring and listening. This involves you analysing your fans' conversations in depth on social networks, pinpointing what they say about you, your products and services, and identifying any opportunities for you to network, be it brand awareness, lead generation, collaboration with other stakeholders, anything that your social media marketing objectives and goals look to achieve. Make it a habit to spend a minimum of 30 minutes in two time intervals during the day, be it the morning and the afternoon, as options such as Twitter lists are great for segmenting and categorizing your fans. As a result, you'll participate genuinely with the viral buzz of what your social fans are talking about, being able to spot any opportunities to, you could say, compete with your rivals, your competitors, and even possibly PR opportunities as well to promote your online reputation. Anything like that, see it as you being a social watchdog. Finally, number 7, assess your metrics and network. If you guys watched one of my previous videos called 5 Problems Business Owners Face with Social Media Marketing, you'll know that I spoke of the metrics, your likes, your shares, your commentary. What are social posts like without these metrics? At the end of the day, you don't just look to post for fun. You want to know what content is performing well, what content isn't performing well. As if you're approaching it from a business perspective, you've always got to realize that these likes, these shares, this commentary are data. Very few people that don't have, you could say, marketing mindset or they're not into social media from that perspective would see it like that. But social marketers truly value your metrics. The more metrics you value, you've got to realize you have to know who to network with based on the metrics. You'll know what people, or you could say, respond the best and what people don't really consider your content to be of value to them. Metrics are very important for your online strategy. You're a human being, so you've got to know that. It's like when it comes to metrics are almost like, you could say, indicators of how people turn on or turn off to your content. See it like that. See that your commentary is also seen as data to assess your customer service, how you can improve your products, how you can improve what you're all about as a business, what people think of you. All this allows you to network effectively and know how to make a great social media experience. Just remember, social media marketing can be a headache, but at the same time, it can also be really fun if you apply the right principles. Are you willing to do that? Thanks a lot again, guys, for watching my video. Don't forget to like, share this video with your business community, startup business, and marketing pros, and comment below for any video suggestions on what you'd like to see for 2017. And just on a personal note, I'd like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year for 2017. Let's all start off on a prosperous note towards success. Have a nice day, guys.